ladies and gentlemen, here he comes, your dream maker, Richard Simmons!
Hey! Hello! Hi!
Hello!
How are you?
Hi! Hi, dreamers! Well, please welcome my correspondent and my announcer, Jerry Penacoli! What a special month this is. This month is dedicated to breast cancer awareness, which is why I'm wearing this pink ribbon today. We also have, and I want you to look over here, we also have a van outside our studio. And we are giving our audience members free mammograms to help to detect any suspicious lumps in the breast. Thank you. Thank you. There's a woman here today who knows about breast cancer firsthand. She's been battling this disease for 5 months, and it's been a very difficult battle. Would you please help me welcome Maria? Can you take us back to when you learned you had breast cancer?
About May. And I was finally diagnosed in June. I didn't have insurance, so I went to a medical clinic. They sent me out to get a mammogram. And they told me they were going to do a lumpectomy. I then called my mom's doctor. And she said, no, I want to see you today. And so she had me come in that day, and she told me I had inflammatory breast cancer. It's a very aggressive kind of breast cancer. And then I went through MRIs, bone scans, all the testing that they do. And it was real scary.
Now, I know people who have gone through a lot of this, and they lose their hair, their eyebrows, the hair on their head. How did you deal with this?
I cried one day.
One day.
One day. And then I said, that's enough of that. I'm taking control. I had my sister come down after my first chemo, and she cut my hair. And then just before it started to fall out, I had my roommate's daughter come and shave my head.
To be ready?
To be ready. I wasn't going to wait for it to fall out, because that's too devastating. I just said, I'm taking control.
Where do you get this? Where do you get the spirit from? This is a hard question. What is your prognosis? Do you know?
If it's inflammatory breast cancer, it's 30%. If it's infiltrating ductal cancer, then it's 65%. And that's what they're thinking it is now. So I'm just very fortunate. I have excellent doctors.
For people who may be watching, or for some people in the audience, what do you want them to know about overcoming cancer?
Oh, just laugh through it. Have a good time through it. I wear Mickey Mouse ears.
I got them here. This lady, and she goes to chemo and radiation wearing these.
People are really scared, but if you laugh every day, don't get down about it, because you're still here. You can have fun with it. You can party with it.
One thing that got you through, your humor got you through, your honesty got you through, your perseverance got you through, but a friend also has helped you a lot. And tell me about your friend.
Terry. I've known Terry for 17 years.
17 years.
17 years. She's one of my best support people. She always has been. We've always been there for each other. She's a wonderful person.
You love her?
I love her.
Everyone, please meet Terry.
Hi, Terry. Don't miss it too much.
Yeah, don't get lipstick.
How long have you known Maria?
About 17 years.
And how did you meet Maria?
Oh, this is really weird.
Well, you know what? After the Mickey Mouse scene, we're ready for anything.
I got divorced after 7.5 years, 17 years ago, and she ended up dating and then getting engaged to my ex-husband. This is really weird, I know. This is really strange. And so he used to tell us different things, and so we hated each other. And we passed each other on a freeway, and I knew she was coming from there, and she knew I was going there. She turned around and met me at the apartment, and he just sat there, and we just went at it and worked it all out. And we've stayed friends for 17 years, and she's not married to him, and I'm not, and he and I are friends, and we've stayed friends for 17 years.
I don't understand. Now, you thought you were coming here to spread the word about breast cancer, but that's not why you really came. Terry had a lot of dreams that she wanted for you. She wanted to give you a boost, a real boost. And I thought that I would go to the finest place that makes the finest wigs for all the Hollywood celebrities. Jerry, tell us about these absolutely gorgeous wigs.
We are giving you a gift certificate for your choice of three of the most beautiful wigs, as Richard said, that all the celebrities wear.
Thank you.
Here's the good part. One day you can be a blonde. The next day you can be a brunette. I personally think that the curly look is very, very pretty.
Definitely.
Okay?
Yeah.
And now, I know because of medical expenses, they're there and there, and I know that you all don't get to talk on the telephone as much because the bills get what?
Really high.
They get high, don't
for
they?
For both of us, yeah.
Okay, because I have to make a lot. You should see my telephone bill. But,
I wouldn't want
but
it.
You want to see something? I want to show. Come over here to my office. Bye, Jerry.
Bye, Terry.
This is my office, and I'd like you to sit here, right there, okay? And I want you to sit here. Now, this is my computer. I have my web page on it, and I use it every day because I get so much email, and I email a lot of my friends because it's cheaper than using the telephone.
Amen.
It is.
It is.
Do you like it?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
This is my own personal one, and I can't think of anyone nicer than to give my computer to you. Because now, look, every day, twice a day, 10 times a day, you can email each other, keep that friendship strong. May this computer keep you close together because you're both going through so much and you need each other right now. I love you.
I love you.
And I love you.
And I love you. God bless you.
Thank you so much.
I hope that you can find strength in your dreams, too. Now, this is so easy to work. It's got the mouth. And they all lived happily ever after. Oh, I just love fairy tales because they all have happy endings. Well, except for one. It's that story of Rapunzel. Oh, she had all that hair. She must have spent all her time brushing and combing it. And can you imagine what she spent on shampoo? I mean, Rapunzel, I think she should have cut her hair. What do you all think? You're about cutting hair. You think she could have? How many? Rapunzel, what do you think? Rapunzel cut? No? Yes? No? Oh. Could you just scoot over a little bit? Yeah. Hi.
Hi, Richard.
You're Carly.
Yes.
How are you, Carly?
I'm fine.
Now, you came with your friends?
Yeah.
What's your name?
I'm Stephanie.
Hello, Stephanie.
I'm Ashley.
Hello, Ashley.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
What do you think, because you have, I mean, the most gorgeous long hair.
Thank you.
Can I cut the ponytail off? Can I cut your hair right here?
Yeah.
Now think about this. I want you to stand up.
Okay.
Don't be nervous, okay?
I am nervous.
You're nervous?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, can look at me.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Can I cut your hair? Yeah. Now turn around.
Below the ponytail.
Okay.
No.
Okay, now turn around. Turn around. Turn around. Turn around. Yeah. Turn around. And you hold this mic.
Okay.
Okay?
Low.
Hello. Hello. I used to be your ponytail. Now, how are you?
I'm shaking.
Are you shaking? Wait, just talk into there. Just talk into there. Okay. How are you feeling?
I'm scared.
You're scared. Now, don't be scared. Don't worry.
Do I look bad?
Could she ever look bad? Could this girl look bad? Could she look bad? No, actually, you wrote me and you wanted to have a dream makeover. Is that true?
Yes.
Okay.
I wanted to get my hair cut.
You wanted to get your hair cut. How long has it been since you've had this much taken off?
Never.
Never?
No. Never.
Never.
No.
Is this brave? I say this is a brave lady. Yes, you're brave, but I want to let you know that this is not just going to go just to the wind, okay? We're donating this hair to Locks of Love. It's an organization that provides wigs to kids with alopecia, which is a hair loss disorder. What do you think of that?
That's good. That makes me feel better.
Does that make you feel good?
Yes.
That's just the tail end. We have, you want a makeover, the best, Mr. Alan Edwards from Alan Edwards Salon.
So,
hi, Alan.
I'm glad it was you who did this.
Huh? Well, no. You know, I was a little nervous. I took the first cut, but now that you see her, what do you plan to do?
Well, what I'd love to do, if she'll do it, we have to sit down and give her a consultation and talk, is get it maybe up in here and cut some hair around the face. And it'll make a huge difference because she's got a great face. We need to frame that face.
She's absolutely, she's
great.
Beautiful.
Wait till you see the makeover. It'll be great fun. Great
so fun. I want you to remember this as you walk back, where this is going and how much this means. Okay?
Okay.
All right.
Okay, let's do it.
You can do a little. You can go over it. And I'm going to add a little dreaming to yours. Don't go away. Don't go away. What do you think? Down. Let me test your memory. Do you remember watching the Dukes of Hazzard on Friday night? With Bo and Luke Duke? Well, there's one woman from New Jersey who said she never, ever missed a show. She's John Schneider's biggest fan. Let's take a look to see what happens when we sent our dream correspondent, Jerry Penacoli, to give her the surprise of her life.
We're here backstage at the Dreammaker studio, and behind that wall is a woman we flew in from Manahawkin, New Jersey. Her name is Charlene. Now, she thinks she's here to be a finalist in the Meet John Schneider contest. You know, the big guy from Dukes of Hazzard. Well, the other two finalists in the contest are actually producers from our show. And what Charlene doesn't realize is her lifelong dream to meet John is about to come true. Lou. Hey.
Hi.
How you guys doing?
Hello.
Hey. I'm sorry about the cameras, you guys, and I'll introduce myself in a second, and I want to know who you guys are. I met you.
You met me.
I met you. But, you know, they like to have everything shot because if you guys do make the cut, they want to know how excited, well, he wants to know how excited you guys are going to be when, you know, and if this ever happens.
Okay? This is the first album that I bought.
You brought it with you?
Yes, I did. I saved money. I got this when I was, I guess, 15 or 16. My mother and father shut my electric off in my bedrooms because I kept playing it over and over and over again. He has the most erotic eyes, bedroom eyes that I've ever seen in my life. Oh my so just heavens. To go like this and just to look at him, we just go, oh my God. It's just like, ah, baby, come here. Get out. All
right. Yeah.
I'm sorry, Joey.
What's up?
Nancy wants to see you.
Okay, Tom, you know what? I am in the middle of doing this.
And I know. I'm sorry. Okay.
Can she wait just a few minutes?
I'll find out for you.
Okay.
All right.
Thanks. Okay. Charlene, you're up. How excited would you get if you were to meet him?
How excited would I get? Oh, my God. I'd be going. John, this is yours, and I love you. I want to take you home with me, but I know you're married. But that's okay. I want you anyway!
You know what? Give me 1 second and let me see what
okay. The
hell she wants. Are you guys okay with water and
yeah,
do you get there's some bagels over there and everything?
I've got money in my purse. Can I pay you off to pick me, maybe?
Hey, come on now. It'll take a little more than money. No. Okay, just stand by. I'll be right back. I'm okay. So sorry. Hey, you guys, why don't you just cut for now? Okay. I'm gonna go get him right now. Come on. John.
Hey, Jerry. Hey, Joey. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Okay, what's up? What's up?
Here's the deal. Oh my God, you brought the general. Lee, I love this. This is great. She is going to die, okay?
Now, she doesn't know.
She's in the middle. Okay, all right. She is about to get the dream of her life come true. John Schneider.
Charlene.
Oh my God!
Charlene, we did it. We pulled it off.
How are you?
These are producers from our show.
Oh my God.
This was all to surprise you.
Oh my God, are you kidding me? Are you kidding?
Is this your dream come true?
Yeah! Oh my God. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my
How
God.
Are you?
Oh my God! Oh my God.
Wow, what a night. That's a surprise for me. What a nice surprise, because you made my day.
Can I hug him now?
Go ahead.
Oh, I can hug him now?
Okay,
oh
all
God,
right.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
Oh my God.
What a nice thing for me. This feels really good.
Well, guess what, you guys? John, Charlene.
Don't even.
Has brought you
something.
A surprise. And we want to take you outside.
Uh-huh.
And we want to show you what that surprise is.
All right, don't open your eyes.
All right, they're not open.
Don't open your eyes.
I promise, I didn't want to.
All right, just stand her right here and have her take a look.
Okay, ready?
Yes.
Okay, open them, Charlene.
Look. Oh my God!
I'm gonna ride shotgun.
You're gonna ride. You're gonna ride.
You're gonna ride. I mean, not shotgun.
You're gonna ride in the back.
Whatever that means.
I'm gonna
go.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, I'm riding in the General Lee.
Back up. I can't get in the door. I've got to do it the original way. Watch yourself, because you grab here.
Yeah! Woo!
That.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Where's the horn?
Where's the horn?
Where's the horn? Yes!
Watch yourself. You ready? Watch yourself. It's a very fast car.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. I'm in Hollywood, California, in the General Lee with John Schneider over here.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Hi. Come back to me. Oh, come on, Dad. Answer the phone.
Hi, it's John Schneider. I'm just delighted. Your daughter is so, she made my day.
Richard Simmons, God bless you. Thank you very much.
Telling you, we know. saved that woman's life. She will never be the same. Never be the same.
What I don't understand is why can't they open the little car doors? I mean, you know, why can't they just... Why does he have to hop in like that?
Well, because they're rusted shut since the 70s. No.
Huh?
No, because he wanted to do it live for her. That's what he always did on the show, and he did... That was part of the fantasy, you know?
Let's thank Jerry. He made another dream come true.
That's fun.
And also, thank you, John Schneider, for making Charlene's dream come true. You're a true dream maker. More dreams are on the way to you! And you! And you! I'd like to ask you a question. Is there a moment in time, almost like a snapshot, that you will never, ever forget? A woman here today keeps the memory of dancing with her father on her wedding day close to her heart. Her father passed away earlier this year. She and her mother have struggled with this loss ever since. Please welcome Susan and her mother, Nena. Susan. Nena. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
How are you, Nena? I've lost my father, too. I know how difficult it is. Tell me why your father was so special to you.
He was a very good man, a great father, a great grandfather to my children, and I miss him very much.
You do miss him much. Nena, can I talk with you? How many years were you married?
58 years.
58 years.
He just passed away in July.
In July? I know these are tough questions. How do you keep his memory alive?
I talk to him. I go to the cemetery and I sit there and talk to him.
But then you had another little loss. Your husband gave you a ring. A diamond ring.
My 25th.
For your 25th anniversary.
And then one day, in the morning, I was washing dishes, and then when I turned around, the prongs were just there. I don't know where I lost it, where I fell.
You lost the diamond.
And I've gone I vacuumed all the house, and all over, I've been looking for it.
And you can't find it. Well, you know, Susan wrote me a letter. And Susan, do you mind reading a little bit of this letter?
Dear Dreammaker, my heart aches every time I see my mother missing my father. We both loved him so much and wish he were still here with us. To make matters worse, 2 weeks after his passing, my mother lost the diamond from her ring my father had given to her on their 25th wedding anniversary. She cannot bear to look at her hand without the ring, as it was a symbol of his love. I know you cannot bring back my father, but if you could help my mother regain a part of his memory, I would be truly grateful.
She wants to bring you good fortune. Do you want good fortune?
Yes.
Do you feel like dreaming? Shall we bring some good fortune to this lady? There's three fortune cookies here. Okay, you hold this.
Okay.
I'm gonna open mine first, okay? Let's see what mine says. Dream and you will find. Okay, now you open yours. And what does it say?
Love will guide the way.
Love will guide the way. Those are nice fortunes. Nena, would you open it, please? The diamond ring is there with the diamond inside! Susan borrowed your ring, and we replaced it with a 1-carat marquee diamond. Every time you look at that ring, I want you to think about this wonderful man who's up in heaven looking at you right now and knowing that you have the ring back.
Thank you.
I hope all of your dreams are heaven sent. Whether it's stamps or coins or shells on the beach, everyone collects something. I want to tell you about another collector. Her name is Trina. She's 15, and she's always dreamed of owning a dollhouse and collecting furniture ever since she was a little girl. We invited her here today to participate in a contest. She hopes to win her dream dollhouse. Oh, but I am the dream maker. Would I let someone leave here without granting their dreams? No! Now, what Trina doesn't know is that she is guaranteed to win. I just can't wait to see the look on her face. Okay, now, she's hidden backstage, and I'm gonna bring her out right now, so don't say anything, okay? Because it's a little game here, okay? Ladies and gentlemen here at Dream Maker, we would like you all to meet Trina! It's Trina! Hi.
Hi.
Well, aren't you just a pretty thing? You look like a little doll.
Thank you.
Now, Trina, tell everyone here, why is a dollhouse, why a dollhouse is so important to you?
Because it's what I wanted all my life. I just want something that I can, like, fix up myself and, like, be proud of that.
And this is like you never had a dollhouse for 15 years? Never had one? What is this?
These are samples of, like, paint and wallpaper to put in my house.
You're very serious about this dollhouse. If you play a little simple game, you could win this dollhouse.
Okay.
All right, come on over here. Now, you will see that there are three tassels here. Okay, come over here. You can see turn around so they can see your pretty face. You can see there's three tassels here. Now, if you pull the right tassel, you will win this dream dollhouse like you've never seen before. Now, if you pull the wrong rope, well then, there's something less desirable than a dollhouse. Now, I'm gonna stay in here. You decide which one that you wanna pull. And we'll see if you get the dollhouse or whatever.
Which one?
Number one? Number two? What are we at? Number one? Number two? Number two? I don't know. Okay, pull it. Pull it. Oh, look. Look. It's a pig.
This is the end of my career as
I
know it.
What the heck is Jerry doing? Say goodbye, Jerry. Some dollhouse with ears, huh? Why don't you try? Now, don't listen to the audience this time because you all led her to that pig. You just pick one or three. Oh, something's happening. Something's happening. Something's happening. Is this a beautiful dollhouse? Trina, this dollhouse is a dream dollhouse, and we're giving you money for all the furniture inside this dollhouse. What do you think? And you stay there. I have the honor of presenting you with the dolls that I do. So you've got a beautiful dollhouse, you have furniture, and you have dolls, and right now you look like a living doll. She got her dream! We're not done dreaming! It's time to see what life is like without hair you could trip on. But here to give us a preview is the man who made it all happen, and a dear friend, Mr. Alan Edwards from the Alan Edwards Salon, and Carly's friends, Stephanie and Ashley!
Are you a little nervous?
I mean, your friend came here with long hair, and it's now on a pillow.
I know.
Tell me this magic that you did.
So we kept it long still because she wanted it long because she's a snowboarder, right? That's what she does. She snowboards, so she needed to pull it back.
Oh, she snowboards.
Right, so we took it over. See, she has sort of a long face, a beautiful face and phenomenal eyes. And we took it over to the side, layered it long layers like this, and did it like a model, like Vogue, you know? And what it did, it gave her face some width, and it brought out her eyes, and it, you're going to see, she looks incredible.
Well, let's first take a look at how Carly came to the Dreammaker. Well, I think it's time now that the new Princess Carly should come make her entrance to the stage. Oh, come here. Ladies and gentlemen, Princess Carly. Wow. Hi, Carly.
Yeah?
So, what do you, tell me how you feel.
Feel relieved.
Relieved. She looks like she has Bambi eyes. Look at her eyes. You like it?
I love it.
You love it. Not like it. You what?
I love it.
You love it. Well, we, Alan, I don't know what to say. Alan Edwards, everyone. Now, this is shampoos and conditioners.
Makeup.
And makeup and everything. A basket of beauty from Alan.
This is to you.
Is she gorgeous? Let's thank Alan Edwards from the Alan Edwards Studio Salon for giving Carly the princess look. What do you girls think? What did we discover about dreams today? Dreams can bring hope to a family who lost a loved one. And dreams can truly give us something to live for. Remember, everyone who's watching and everyone here, you have a dream. Keep dreaming. God bless. Thank you all.